27 cars and bikes that have been nominated this year for the 2011 CNBC TV 18 Overdrive Awards. We have cars that start at 3 lakh rupees, going all the way up to 35, 40 lakh rupees. Our jury members, they're going to be testing them, evaluating them.
Size of the car, the drivability, the fuel efficiency, the space inside.
Overall, a car that I'm extremely pleased with.
It says what it does on the cover, I think.
And I think we have some customers now who want quality.
I'm sure this is the car that I would want to buy.
Welcome back to our coverage of the CNBC TV 18 Overdrive Awards Jury Round. We're at the MMSC racetrack in Chennai, where last week you saw us evaluating the contenders for Car of the Year. Over the next half hour, we're going to look at the SUVs, bikes and scooters that are in contention for these awards.
Start this week with SUVs and a crossover that finally made its debut in India this November. While its funky looks may not find universal favour, the Skoda Yeti is a competent soft-roader, and its excellent interiors and build quality found favour with our jury.
I think as an SUV, it's an interesting package. Okay, from what I've heard of people who've gone to the showroom to look at the Yeti, there are people who are immediately put off by the looks, and there are just as many people who are immediately turned on by how funky it looks, right? So the Yeti is a polarizing opinion situation in terms of styling alone.
I'm not too impressed with the styling, but a little boxy. The front end is a little low for me, and things like that just doesn't gel. But otherwise, on the overall, the product is good.
I like the looks for sure. It's definitely my taste, and I think the engineers have done a brilliant job with the suspension, the way they've tuned it.
The Yeti is powered by Skoda's 2-litre diesel engine, which also does duty on the Lora. It produces 140 PS of power, 320 Nm of torque, and is mated to a 6-speed manual gearbox. While the base variant is 2-wheel drive, the fully loaded Elegance spec comes with the Halidex 4-wheel drive system with hill descent control, good enough for moderate off-roading. But this is a crossover that does its best work in the city and on the highway.
The engine, typical Skoda, very, very strong, torquey diesel. So I overall, I thought it was quite nice. I'm not convinced on the looks, but generally I thought it was quite nice.
It's a little stiff for the town, I'd say. But then at the same time, if you want to load the car up and, you know, go out of town, head out of town with your family, it's going to be perfectly sprung. And even if you want to take it soft-roading, I think it's going to take the bumps pretty well.
I can see a lot of people buying this car just to move around in the cities and to go soft-roading for their weekend trips out.
As a functional SUV, it's a nice soft-roader. It'll do everything that you can think of. And it's a Skoda, so quality levels are typically very good. I think the perception is that the price is a little higher than it should have been, but I think that will sort itself out. It's not a deal-breaker, really.
Tata Motors has been making low-cost utility vehicles and SUVs for a while now. But this year, the company took a major step up from the Sumo Grandes and Safaris with this, the new Ariya. Its first attempt at a premium crossover. The Ariya sports some attractive and muscular styling, but the fully loaded cabin was equally impressive to our jury.
The styling, I love it. No, it's an MUV, so it's a very practical MUV, but the way they've styled it, it's got those butch wheel arches, the front looks really aggressive, very powerful, the stance, everything, spot on. Good job on the styling.
The Ariya, it was you know, a big step up from I think anything Tata has made before. Definitely, I think again the interiors in that was really nice, very very modern. You know, lots of compartments. So you know, if you want to do long trips to places like Kodaikanal, like myself, I think it's quite nice.
At 14 lakh rupees, you do get a lot of features in that car, which you do not get in cars that are priced higher than that as well. And for that, yes, you will pay a premium. Forget, no, let's not say premium, but yes, all those features do cost a lot of money. The point here to note is that Tata Motors have made a serious attempt at going up market, and it works wonderfully well.
Tata's latest crossover is powered by the same 2.2-litre Dicot diesel engine we first saw on the Safari and Sumo Grande. But while the basic architecture is similar, Tata Motors engineers have tweaked the power plant for better performance and refinement.
I thought the engine lacked a little bit compared to the Yeti. But in general, you know, a huge step up from anything that's come out of Tata before, I think.
The Ariya is a fantastic package. It's a nice, well-built crossover. It's got 4x4, it's got a nice engine, it's got fantastic powertrain. It handles well, it rides well, it's spacious, comfortable. I mean, what more do you want? Tata Motors have certainly gone leagues ahead of themselves.
We may have only two contenders for the Made in India SUV of the Year award, but it was a busy year for imported off-roaders. Here's a look at the nominees for Import SUV of the Year.
Now that our jury have finished testing and evaluating the contenders, the SUVs, we're going to take a short commercial break. But when we come back, we're going to be moving on to bikes. And as you can see, we have the most amazing lineup of bikes coming up.